Welcome back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show. Feel free to get in touch with us on our socials right below your screen. Tell us where you're watching from or how you are faring with your business. I've seen conversations of people saying technology can spur growth in the different business space. Yes, I actually did attend a meeting where about 110 women were passed out, women entrepreneurs were passed out after a boot camp that was aimed at helping them understand how they can integrate, you know, technology into their businesses and also grow their sales. I must say it's an amazing move by JIZ and partners, and maybe this is something that we can look into. Equally, I've seen Uma talking about how they will, you know, have the trade fair, and this year they're looking at digitization and how technology can ease operations in the manufacturing sector, I should say. Yeah, so good stuff. The trade fair will be happening come October, and Vision Group is actually one of the main sponsors there. So we shall have that for you to see what you need to learn about your business and also the opportunities that technology can bring for you in your business. Time now for how to make money.
Josephine Akafero, the CEO and creative designer of Jose House of Creations. We are a house of creations that makes a range of products ranging from shoes, from clothes, cushions, furniture, upcycled puff seats, coasters, a range of products, because we do not only limit ourselves to clothes like most businesses do when it comes to fashion. So that's why we say, we call ourselves Jose House of Creations. Imagine a house that is able to produce a range of things. So you just come through, you mention it, and we make it. I started this business some time back, though it wasn't my main source of income. It was my side gig. And I was into employment then. But I used to just find a little time to get into my passion, which is the fashion and design. And then I was not even doing most of the products that I am making right now. So fully, I ventured into my passion, which is this business, in 2017. That's when I quit employment and I went into entrepreneurship, a journey that has been a roller coaster, but worthy venturing into, because it has taught me a lot of things and it has made me the person I am today and everything I have achieved. I started it with not so much money, because I had not saved that much money. That's why you always tell people, whoever comes to me for advice when it comes to business and entrepreneurship, I always tell them, you don't need a lot of capital for you to start, because when you wait to save that money, you will waste all of it because you will not know how to use it. So start with a little, fall, get up, fall, get up. So it teaches you, the business itself will teach you the best lessons you need. Not even any universal institution or high institution of learning will teach you business and entrepreneurship practically, like the business itself. So I started with around 500,000, which I used to pay for the rent, only rent. So the rest of the things, I got most of the things from my house where I was staying to come and use it, to have a nice lounge for the business, for people to come through and be able to support me. And that's how I started my hustle. It wasn't easy, but I said, I have no return ticket. I am going all in for it. And here I am. I didn't start here. I was somewhere else, but today I am standing here. I love shoes. And I know in the era we are in today, people wear shoes. Gone are the days where people used to even move in sandals, sandals, or barefoot. So these days, as fashion has evolved, people wear shoes and they love comfort. So one of the main shoes that I normally use are All-Stars, because they're comfortable and you can always wear them as casual shoes, or you can even wear them for a party depending on how you choose to match them with whatever that you're going to wear. So I decided to venture into the shoes, because people buy shoes, people love shoes, and it's one way that I could incorporate my passion, which is designing using an African print, normally commonly known as a kitenge, that I can give it to people and they not only look at them as kitenge for clothes, because in Africa most people think that kitenge is only to be worn as clothes. So I wanted to give people a variety of ways of being able to use a kitenge, not only in clothes. So that's where I specialized in African, or what we call Ankara shoes. We call them Ankara shoes, yes. In business and entrepreneurship, one of the things that I've learned, the moment you chase away a problem, you'll not be able to prosper and grow. Every business has got its own challenges at all scaling. So in my business, I choose to look at challenges as opportunities, as much as I'm going to mention about them, but I don't want them to go away because they make me better every time they challenge me. So every time they challenge me, they teach me something. By the time I come out of that challenge, I'm a new person. That's one of the things, the principles of entrepreneurship that I've learned. Gone are the days where you see a problem and you're like, I wish God can take this problem away. So the moment God takes away that problem, that means you're not going to learn and you'll not get to the next level. So one of the challenges we had from the beginning was to make Ugandans and Africans at large that you can actually wear a kitenge shoe, or what we call Ankara shoes, because for them it was more or less just buying imported products and you wear, that's all. As much as most of our clients are expatriates and whites, they appreciate this work because it's creativity. So it wasn't easy to make a Ugandan or an African person, Ugandan in particular, that, you know what, buy this African, this Ankara shoe, and it is beautiful, it's unique, it's different. And the person would ask you, why are you selling it this much? That's a lot of money if I can access it on market at a cheaper price. But there is a difference between class and something ordinary. So if you want something different, something beautiful and unique, you have to invest in it. And that wasn't easy, but along the way, we were able to manage to convince them, just like for the car tires. People see car tires as, most especially when you're just removing it from your car, as waste. So you're just going to throw it away and it's done. So for me to be able to convince an ordinary Ugandan that, you know what, buy this product, it's made out of a car tire, it wasn't easy. Actually, it was one of the toughest things that I faced in business, but I kept going, I didn't give up. I said, I'm going to add value to this car tire, make it as a puff seat, make it as a coffee table, and make it as a chair for you to be able to use it. So those are some of the questions that I used to get. Why are you making me buy a car tire at that much? Value addition is very important. That's why when you buy, let's say, I give an example of a cow. A cow can give you a variety of products. It can give you meat, it can give you milk, it can give you... So it depends on what you do to add value to that product that you get from a cow. By the time you add value to it, that means you're spending. So when you spend, that means the value, the cost of that product is not going to remain the same. It's the same thing with us when it comes to the products that we make. The moment we add value to what we're doing, it takes the price up. So it's upon someone to appreciate that level of creativity and hard work that we add into this for them to come and support and buy the products that we make at Joe's House of Creations. And that's fulfilling. I'm so confident and proud and happy that we are able to do this. Not so many people do that. The other thing I would say, probably the taxes that are involved along the way, but still they're not going to go away. So we choose to embrace them and you see how are we going to turn this around so that we keep going, because every time you keep looking at a problem as a problem, it will stay there and you'll not go anywhere. Or you quit, but I'm not actually quitting, is not even anything that I look at in my life. The quality of what we produce is what makes our products quite costly. So if you're looking at something that is unique, beautiful, and classy, something that is not going to be everywhere. That's why you do not see many people doing what we do. There are many people into the fashion business, but you don't find any with all the range of products that Joe's House of Creations makes. So that alone makes us stand out. So if we are able to give you something that you're not going to find everywhere on the street, that is already enough, that is worth you spending your money on the products that we make. Me, I feel the government can do better. As much as there are so many empowerment campaigns here and there that they are being carried out, but I don't think they are really that much satisfying to the young entrepreneurs. They are those well-established entrepreneurs. They were given incentives that has helped them. Even actually foreign investors are given many opportunities for them to invest in a country where they don't even charge. Let's say they are given free land, they are not spending any money to open up all those big, exactly, and then free taxes. If only can they actually provide such incentives to young entrepreneurs like us. We have the brains. We have the brains and we are very creative that we are making products that if only we are being supported well enough by our government, our economy would be way better compared to some other economy or to the years back. But the fact that we are not being facilitated that much, it limits our productivity. by now you would even be seeing most of these products in different stores in France, in Europe, all over, in the US, because they are marketable products. Yes, but in 2019 I was in Paris. I was privileged to be taken to Paris by the French government. I tried to move around because as a creative I wanted to acquire more knowledge to be able to come back home and use it and be able to make my work better. I moved to different stores, fashion creative stores, fashion related stores. I did not find any African Ugandan to be specific, products being sold in these places. Not my products in particular, because by then I was not the person I am today, but any other creative or any other entrepreneur in Uganda. But I was able to find Kenyan products, surprisingly. And it was actually so disappointing that is how it felt like. How can Kenyan economy be that good that these countries take on their products and they sell them? And Uganda is nowhere. Uganda is a very rich country. If only we have better policies put in place and we are being supported, because it helps our country, it helps our economy. It's not just about me, Jose, as a person, but it's about our entire country, because when I succeed, my country succeeds. People are getting employment. Young people are motivated and inspired by Josephine as a person, but they have no idea what it takes to stand this brand as Jose House of Creations. If only, that's why when you see white countries, Western countries, they are being supported. When they see someone doing something through and they support them so that they push. It is not about the person in particular. It's about what this person is pushing forward to the interest of their government. And at the end of the day, they make it. Me, I would say, I always tell people, it doesn't have to be in millions of money for you to start. I started with my passion. I believed in my dream. Regardless of whatever we look at as challenges, I didn't stop. I will not say that it kept flowing, that it was a bed of roses. It was a roller coaster. It was full of the bumps, the highs, the lows. But I believed in myself. My passion kept pushing me and I didn't give up. So I would tell any young person out there, be determined with what you want. Be passionate about it, because when you do what you love, there is a saying that if you don't do what you love, you are wasting time. That even when you have a slight challenge, you will give up, because that's not what you love. You're just there because you're there for survival. So even if you start right now, you cannot say you're going to start a business and you want to have a very expensive space for rent, because that's one of the challenges that people face when it comes to renting. You can even start from your home. Grow your business. Right now, the platforms are there for you to advertise your business and people get to know them. You can have an online store. Gone are the days where you have to have a physical location for you to sell. If you have an online store and you're doing very good work, and even if you're selling from home, you can be able to make it. Like in these developed countries, it's not everyone that is actually having a store or a space, a physical location. But for as long as you have good work and you are able to deliver to the people, you are good to go. I am proud of my business because it has grown to where it is today, that I have this shop where I am, and I have a branch in Jinja, and I have another branch in Entebbe, and being able to employ other young people and passing on the knowledge, like training and mentoring other people into what I do. That's one of the things that I take much pleasure in and I don't take for granted. It's fulfilling on my side, because I know I am playing a big role to the country, that even after years, when I'm no longer into this industry, someone will be able to proudly say, Jose contributed to what I am today.
Why do you think Ugandans do not appreciate products made in our country?
Because some of them have not given them a reason to. So every time, when I was starting out, I didn't know how to make people know, to appreciate this, until when I learned that if you give someone a reason to buy your product, they will give you the money. Then it wasn't easy, but right now an ordinary Ugandan spends that much money and buys this shoe, which wasn't easy then when I was starting out, because it was the same question: why are you making me pay that much money if I can go downtown and I get that All-Star at 25 or 30,000 or 50,000? But right now I gave them a reason to buy it. So I give you the worth of the money that you're spending. My last remarks to everyone watching, when you're doing what you're doing, don't give up, first of all. Don't look at challenges as challenges. Look at the challenges as opportunities for you to elevate and become better. Be passionate about what you're doing, and above all, put God at the midst of everything you do. You will succeed.
So there you go, how to make money. Very important for you that is planning to start out something. We should be visiting more, you know, entrepreneurs just to highlight some of the things they're doing unique that you need to pay attention to as a business person or a potential business person, and also see if you can pick or borrow a leaf from them and start up your business. Now, let's then talk you through personal finance tips for this week. And so we're looking to run a whole month series on personal finance tips. And this week we'll start with just how viable your business is, yeah? And we're asking, are you a startup or established business? The bottom line for you is that you will need a business model that is actually, you know, lucrative. It can work, or viable, for lack of a better word. So we'll start off with Mr. Enoth Baine, who is the CEO at MedConsult, who tells us about why you need a viable business venture or a model that is viable. Now, when we talk about viable, it must be concise, it must be solution-oriented. Is it something that offers solutions to society, or you just, you know, looking for money? Let me run you through the personal finance tips for this week. I'll see you shortly.
Hello. Good evening, viewers. My name is Enoth Mbeine, your business coach. I welcome you to yet another very exciting business session. And today, we're going to talk about the business model of your business. Why is it important for you to have a business model? A business model is a plan for your business to make profits. Many of us out there don't really understand and know what exactly we are doing in business. So you need to understand exactly your formula of your business. And this brings me to a very exciting topic of what we call a business model canvas. A business model canvas is a tool that helps us to analyze deep our businesses, to be able to understand it better, so that we can make our businesses grow. A business model canvas can also help us to understand the key functions of our business so that we can prepare to be able to attract funding or investment. For example, if you want to get a loan from a bank is very interested to know if you have a business model. Why is it important for us to have a business model? Not having a business model is like doing things in the dark. When you wink, nobody will see you. But when you have a business model, you have a plan in your mind. You have a roadmap to where you want to go. You want to grow, you want to open up new branches, you want to open up another business revenue stream. The business model will inform us. So this is exciting. In this particular session, that I introduce you to what we call a business model canvas. A business model canvas was invented by an American called Ostergaard, and it's becoming a very popular tool in the business world currently for us to understand our businesses. So the business model canvas has 9 blocks, what we normally call the building blocks, that we use to be able to analyze the business. First and foremost, we have what we call the key partners. Key partners. So key partners are the key people that you work with, the key people that drive your role and mission of your company. Key partners, for example, suppliers. Suppliers of your raw materials to a company. Those will be key partners. Then secondly, we look at key activities. So the business model canvas will now look at the key activities. What are the key activities that you are undertaking to be able to meet the value proposition of your business? Key activities could be selling. You would be participating in selling. You could probably be in production. So these are the activities that you do on a daily basis. So it's important for you to analyze in detail the key activities. Then thirdly, we look at the value proposition. This is perhaps one of the most important blocks in the business model canvas. So the value proposition helps us to understand what benefits that you're offering to your customers. Why should a customer choose your business or your product and not the other? What key benefits are you offering out there to the market? Is it affordability? Is it accessibility? Is it the convenience? Is it the good customer care? So these are the value proposition elements we need to dig into a business. So what is your value proposition? Then furthermore, in the business model canvas, we also look at the customer segmentation. This is another very key important block for your business. Who are the customers that you are serving? Which customers are you targeting? How have you segmented these customers? Is it the working class? Is it the corporates? Are you targeting schools? Are you targeting youth? Are you targeting women? Is your product targeting a specific market? And in customer segmentation, we use different parameters. For example, demographics. We can social culture, the lifestyle of other people, so that you're able to target that particular market. So in a business, we should be able to understand what our customer segmentation is. This is very, very critical for us to understand our business and be able to prepare our products specifically and design them for that particular market that we have analyzed.
So there you have it. If you're running a model and you're not sure whether it's viable or not, then you have every reason to watch us for the next 3 weeks, because we have different business models that you need to adopt. Or if you're planning to start a business, you need to see which one of them can work for you before you embark on that business. Okay? That should do for personal finance for this week. Time now for the Forex and Money Market Report. Alright, so the shilling has been holding at about 3,700 for the last few weeks. We now hope that this can stay on for a while. But fuel prices look to be going up again. I've seen major petrol stations going to about 5,100. Doesn't sound good, yeah? We've been used to about 4 something. If it goes up, we know what impact that has on businesses. So we can only hope that, you know, maybe some things are sorted so we can go back to the 4.548 mark that has been for major petrol stations. So much happening in the world of business, from insurance to Toraco Microfinance that did open officially here in Uganda after getting that license to be one of the underwriters in the industry as well. And of course, there's much more that you need to pay attention to in the world of business. That's it for this week. Thank you so much for making time. I need to send a special shout out to my friends. I have, there's one Doreen in Jinja. Yes, I have Eddie in Bale. And there's another guy in Gulu. What's his name? Benson. Yes. Thank you so much for watching The Business Show. Yeah. Feel free to get in touch with us on our socials. My name is Simon. From me and the rest of the team, we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.